Hi, I'm Nivedita Indrajit in conversation with the learning coach Vinod Kumar. And I know you because we registered for one of your programs a couple of days back. The space learning, the simulation that you did to show the universe to the kids sitting at home. So that is the brief introduction I'll give about you. And I'll let you talk about how you got into all this and whatever other work that you do.
Super. So I'm a second generation entrepreneur.
Okay.
So my father runs a catering, marriage catering, unit.
Okay.
I've always been a very independent guy when it comes to my choices.
Okay.
So I chose what I wanted to study. So obviously it was a very wrong choice. So after my 12th, I wanted to become a scientist and grow a beard. So neither of which I have been able to achieve till this point. So I wanted to become a scientist and went down to a college and wanted to become a biotechnologist because that was kind of like the hot thing that was happening in 2002, 2003, I believe. So, but I was in my computer science degree and the college was not able to offer me a biotechnology course. So
okay.
They said, why don't you take up biochemistry?
Okay.
And probably in your post graduation you can choose biotechnology.
Okay.
So I took biochemistry and it was 3 years of hell going through because I had no clue what biology was and chemistry was my lowest point in my studies. So
okay.
After I finished this, started understanding why I made those mistakes and I am. Someone who's kind of like, a little privileged when it comes to technology right from my young age. So I think from my 5th, 6th grade onwards, I have been, brought up with computers. Access to internet was always available to me. So
okay.
If this is going to be a situation for someone with access to technology, so then imagine thousands and tens of thousands of, people who wanted to become engineers just because engineering was giving them a stable income job.
Right.
So in 2008, there was kind of a spark on, is there something that we could do to help these children identify what is their, innate passion, what is their innate talent in choosing an engineering career. So I did not have the scope to go down there and teach children about career, but I knew about how not to make a wrong choice. So the idea was, can I take in a 4th grade or a 5th grade or 6th grade student and teach him the basics of engineering? So, and make him aware of, different fields of engineering so that when he wants to become an engineer or if he wants to become an engineer, he knows what he wants really. So
right.
He will not just follow the next door neighbor who studied mechanical engineering and got a job with Infosys as a coder.
Yeah.
So this was the idea in 2008, along with a friend of mine, we started off Technology Robotics.
Okay. Bharat.
So, yeah. The idea
okay.
was that, yeah, we would inspire kids to make the right decision in their career.
Okay.
So I think from then on, when we started, we had this vision that we would start working on inspiring kids through STEM education, first through robotics,
okay,
and then through astronomy, and then through game design.
Okay.
So that's my start as an educator, in the field.
Okay.
Ever since then, I've been working very closely with kids. I love teaching them, and my core strengths, as I see, is that I'm very good at simplifying things. So life is already complex, so you just need simple things to happen around you. So I'm very
yes.
good at simplifying things.
Okay.
So with my forte, I have been working with schools on creating learning experiences for kids, helping teachers to create unique learning experiences inside classroom, so
mm-hmm.
that learning becomes an experience. It doesn't become a chore or it doesn't become a burden for them.
Right.
So this is me.
So I actually want to share like feedback, like the 2 days back, my son attended your program, right? So when he goes for a bath, he sits in a small tub like thing and sometimes he puts in soap. So what he was doing is he's making the space over there, and he was saying, okay, this is how it is raising, or, you know, he's trying to make a shape of a bone, shape of a dinosaur. Mm-hmm. Now he's looking at the clouds more often and saying, okay, I see this shape here, or I see that shape. So that's like a feedback I'm eager to give.
Thank you.
And so, Ken,
why we wanted to do that was that the one other reason about the tour of the universe, especially, is that we find a lot of children that too after the lockdown hooked on to the TV or mobile phone because there is no other alternative. So parents kind of like, even I have two children, so I'm kind of like scared to send my children down to play because there's some construction work happening and we do not know who has what, and it's kind of like, you know, a really scary situation for parents. So with no other alternative, we are just left out to give them the TV remote and or the mobile phone or the laptop and say, hey, you manage for some time.
Yeah.
So we were thinking, hey, is it possible for us to really bring about an impact with whatever is available with the children at home?
Mm.
So that's how Superstar Gazer came into play. So before the tour of the universe, we had Superstar Gazer program. So Superstar Gazer program was very simple. Hey, can I teach my child to spend 1 hour or 1.5 hour every day under the sky? So he can just go sit down over there and he can, you know, count the stars, make shapes. So I've actually, as a kid, I have done all those things. But unfortunately, my children don't care about what is up there. So there are some twinkly stuff, you know, in the sky. So that came into play, and it was kind of like a trial and error. So we wanted to check if children would be interested, and caught on like a fire, and within 7 weeks we had catered to close to, you know, 800 students.
Okay. Constellations are always interesting, actually.
So see, the sky is something very, very interesting. It's just that we are not taught, or, you know, that information has never been passed down to us through any avenue. So only for those privileged who had the extra effort to go and search for what is up there, they knew what is up there. For all the others, it's just basic sunrises that's in the west, you know, blah, blah, blah. And if it is something to do with Mars, probably parents would be interested to pursue. But if not, they just, you know, leave it off. So it went on very good, and kids started asking, hey, what next after? So right now you have taught us to see the skies. So, but we just see the stars. So what is there in there? So in the Superstar Gazer program, we teach them to how to simulate the skies in the night and, you know, check for themselves using a free tool.
Okay.
So, but that was a 2D tool. So students started mastering it and like, sir, what next? What next for us? So that's when this idea came about. We also run a planetarium. So we also run Space Truck Planetarium, where we work with 900,000 schools in Southeast Asia.
Okay.
So we said, okay, is it possible for us to take the planetarium software with which how we create shows? Can we create a customized show for kids so that we can show them not just what is there in the sky, but what is there in our universe? So they're kind of like, you know, I always tell my students that the problems that your child is going to face tomorrow, okay, do not exist today.
Yeah.
So to you know, to address a problem which do not exist today, they need two things. So first thing that they need is inspiration, and the next thing they need is creativity.
Yeah.
So unfortunately, most schools do not foster on either of these two things. So creativity is cut when you, or creativity will happen with your child only if you're school.
Imagination is also not nurtured in that sense.
Imagination, there's nothing such sort of, you know, imagination.
Yeah.
So, see, both these two things are nurtured. It's how do you call it in mathematical? Yeah, directly proportional to the school fees that you pay. Okay. So, if your child is there in a school which collects, you know, 1.5 lakhs, then they let your child, you know, imagine. If your child is studying in the school which will charge you, you know, 20,000-25,000 rupees, there's no such thing as imagination. There's no such thing as, you know, inspiration. So what we wanted to do is, you know, see if we can inspire them, if we can give them back their imagination and say, hey, there's so much out there. You guys can, you know, start imagining, start, you know, formulating things and open up their creativity.
Okay.
So that is the idea behind why we came up with the program, and what is happening, in there.
This is so beautiful. Thank you so much. And all the links that were there, the Smart Ninja, we'll be putting the links in there, and even the Facebook links that we have. Is it okay to put all those links can reach out?
So, the Tour of the Universe and Superstar Gazer are part of Learn Space Science. So, Learn Space Science was another experiment. What was happening was that I'm a Ramakrishna Mission student. So, my Swamiji always used to ask me, who are you? So, who am I defines what I'm going to become. Swami Vivekananda says this excellent word about education. He says, education is the manifestation of perfection already in man. Okay, the important focus. So, if I'm going to tell this thing to people and ask you, what is the important word in that sentence? So, can you? What is the important word in this sentence? Education is the manifestation of perfection already in man.
I feel it's mankind over there.
So, the most important word, what he tries to say is, it's already in you. It's not something that, I am going to pour.
The learning.
You are going to get it. It's already there. Whatever Einstein knew, you know, and I know.
Yeah, it's the so knowing it's you mean.
That, it's just that, we don't, want to bring it out.
Right.
So the role of a teacher is, for me to bring that out. My role is not to put something into you.
This is an amazing piece of conversation. Thank you.
So everything that they have to know, they are already born with. So every day, every time that I do the tour of the universe, I also do another program with kids where we create solar systems.
Okay.
Simulate and we create solar systems. So every time I'm in the simulation and, talk to kids and do that, there is some kind of a cosmic thing that happens for all of us to exist. And as Swamiji said, it's all there in us. It's all there in each and every one of us. It's just that you need the right person, right tools to bring those things up.
We somehow move towards validation in this whole process instead of knowing.
Yes. So, as you said, validation, we have just skipped the process.
Yeah.
So we just moved to the end process and said, hey, this is what, you are and, kind of stuff like that. So the idea was, hey, can we bring about this joy of, learning, the joy of, creating to kids? So I was working for I have about 13, 14 years of classroom experience, working in like 3-4 countries. So we were thinking, hey, is it possible for us, for the 21st century kids, to start creating content? So the moment that they start create content, they start phoning up their learning. So can we bring in a little bit of flipped classrooms? Can we bring in a little bit of, blended classrooms? Can we bring in a little bit of project-oriented classrooms and create a unique personalized experience center for kids? So that's the idea, and we came up with a concept called steadfast learning.
Okay.
So steadfast learning is making your children from being a consumer of knowledge to become a creator of knowledge.
Okay.
So it's not what they learn that matters, but what they do with what they learn. So what you said right now is steadfast. So what your child does right now. So it's not about him listening to what I'm saying, but what is he doing later to it? So he starts, making things. So we could probably give him more work to do. He could start sharing what he learned with others. So kind of, a sequential step which a child can take to own up their learning curve. So that's how Space Science Learning Club was formed. And we have had fantastic success in implementing it in schools.
Okay.
So, with that, we were thinking, hey, okay, in one part in science, we were able to implement it. So is it possible for us to implement it in different parts? So can we implement steadfast in English? Can we implement steadfast in learning mathematics? Can we implement steadfast in learning history? So we started experimenting with a lot of things, and the end result of that experimentation is Smart Ninja.
Okay.
So we found a perfect partner with Flint. Smart Ninja is a preschool. So right now it's a preschool, but what I envision is that Smart Ninja would become an integrated learning studio. So why should schools have 500 kids?
Yeah.
So schools can just exist with 30 children.
Mm-hmm.
So we can give them personalized learning. Ultimately, the schools came into existence for certain end goals to achieve. So, but those end goals are not
relevant
not relevant. So yeah. They have changed, I think, 20 years back, but we are still holding on to
it.
So see, today most of the job losses and stuff like that are directly related to what we have learned in the school. So people do not have skills. So they have a degree, they have, you know, knowledge, but they do not have skills. So we are not taught how to, you know, learn a skill.
Right.
So Smart Ninja is a work in progress on working in creating skill-oriented learning for kids using Steadfast. So we can create micro schools kind of concepts.
Okay.
So that is what we are working on, Smart Ninja.
Oh, this is so nice. Actually, it's nice that you're telling me this, because my son goes to a school which does project-based learning. It talks about imagination and stuff. And what the principal once told was, pardon me?
Is it a Waldorf school?
Not really. There's partly Jidamurti, Krishnamurti philosophy, and partly Walden methodology, and partly, I think even the founder has 30, 40 years in experience where he wanted to learn so much more than what was being taught in a school. So in conversation with him, one of the days, he mentioned the problems that we have as adults will not be the problems of your children. They will be more climatic, they will be more environmental, and it will not be, they will have plenty of money, they'll have plenty of to-do options for career and all that. But what they are going to face is something different. So we need to really, thank you for contributing to that part of it.
Thank you so much.
Is there anything else that you'd like to say, or?
I was
tempted to ask you, can we have a simulation? But I know it's like this occurred to me right now. I mean, but then no, I think we'll give
maybe
the
one other day. One other day we can, you know, invite a few more kids.
Yeah.
From your community, and we could do a separate simulation for them.
Yeah.
So we are all about, you know, reaching out. As a student of Ramakrishna, I'm always, like, you know, obliged to pass on knowledge.
Yeah.
So, wherever I can, however I can, you know, touch kids' lives, I'd be more than happy to do that.
So, yes.
Do let me know at a place and time, and we could, you know, do a small simulation for kids.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Nivedita. So happy I'm here, and, you know, I'm sharing my life's vision.
Okay. Yes.
So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bye-bye.